welcome back to my channel. It's Tamitou here. Today's build is going to be a spring wedding venue, and my last wedding venue that I built seemed to go down really well, so I thought I'd make a new one. I tried to make it as different as I could, but I really like the idea of the spring theme, and now that we have seasons, we can obviously time the weddings and have winter weddings. I didn't even think about winter weddings. I'm gonna have to do another one themed around winter as well, but for now I wanted the center of this to be this like little raised platform with the glass roof. It's almost like a bit of a what's it called, like a glass house or something, but it's just a really small one. And yeah, the little lot has got everything you'll need. There's going to be a dance floor area, a public bathroom just to make it easy instead of building a whole lot, like a building with a bathroom and everything. And then there's going to be a photography area and a bar, seating and food and music and everything. So yeah, it's got everything you need for the special day. And here I'm just sort of picking out random items in the catalogue that I wanted to put in or thought I might put in, and like I said, I was trying to keep it different from another wedding venue that I've done. Now, I didn't record a speed build on that because that was done before I started YouTube actually. It's on my gallery. I'll put a picture of it in now. It's called the Rustic Barn Wedding, I think, and I updated it when Cats and Dogs came out, and it seems to go down really well. It's got like over 1,000 downloads, so if you're into venues or you need one, you can't be bothered to make your own, then go check it out. And obviously this one will be up on the gallery as well, probably before I've uploaded this video, so you can go and take your pick. And yeah, just have a nice venue all set up for your special day for your Sims. And now, you know, with seasons, like I said, we can have you know, the weather might, you know, it might ruin your day, I don't know, but you know, if it starts raining or something in spring, which it can do a lot, if you haven't played with it already, it's something that happens. You know, your Sims, I guess, can all run under here and like shelter. At least there's something to shelter on. But yeah, there's loads of items that were added with seasons, decor wise, like garlands, hanging things, like you can see all in the catalog right now, that actually work so well specifically for weddings. I was actually really pleasantly surprised. There's things like table decorations, floral decorations, paper flowers, which I do something cool with quite soon, which you'll see. It's so nice. Yeah, so I ended up, like, I didn't go overboard with items, I don't think, but there's definitely a lot of ideas there and a lot of things you can use from seasons in terms of weddings. So in a way, we kind of got a little update to weddings as well as other occasions throughout the year. So like, for example, look at this little flower wreath. There's so many cute little things that I just wanted to add, but at the same time I didn't want it to be like, it's one of those builds that could have gone forever and I could have just kept adding and adding and adding things, but it wouldn't have looked I don't know, it would just look too cluttered, and you know, so I had to stop at some point. So you know, I added these rose petals down the middle of the aisle instead of that rug. I just thought it looked more delicate and it kind of looked more temporary, because as you can see, this is more like a temporary outdoor setup, so this wouldn't be here all year round. It's like the company that you hire set it up for you for the wedding or whatever. So the rose petals have just like been tossed down the aisle. And here I am putting a photo booth area, which I know a lot of people probably don't think to put in their Sims wedding, but I really like to take photos when I'm playing with a certain family and I put them in their house. And what I did is create this amazing backdrop, which totally works because I've player tested everything. And it's just like this really nice floral backdrop made of paper flowers that I've seen all over Pinterest in real life weddings. And as soon as I saw this item in seasons, that's what I thought of, and I was like, I have to make a venue. So that whole idea of this venue is basically focused around those paper flowers, so that's where the idea came from. And I just love that little detail. So yeah, like I said, it does work. I've player tested it, and you'll see that in the screenshots and in the kind of the shots that I've put at the end of the video. And you'll see like a wedding happening, and you'll see Sims, you know, having a good time here, and you'll see it all full and lively. And yeah, you'll see that there's the bride has her photo taken there, so it totally works. As does the wedding arch, because I kind of merged two arches together. The wedding arches, there's only two, they're really boring, I get bored of them really fast. So I added this downsized romantic garden stuff pack one. And then, of course, I had to add some blossom trees and some other trees dotted around, some roses, just to fill in the gaps here and there. And yeah, like I said, the public bathroom was a lot easier to add. You can get that out of debug if you put your BB dot show hidden objects cheat on, and it's just a lot easier than building a little bathroom. Yeah, so, and I also put the buffet table, the banquet table, instead of building a kitchen. That's the other thing. Don't bother hiring a caterer, just serve the food on that table. Obviously, you can put the wedding cake in the middle, which you will have to bring yourself, but that's about the only thing you need to do beforehand. And you can cook that even if you're a level one skill cooking, so that's not a problem. And yeah, and I just added these little floral decorations on the piano, on the bar. It's kind of to keep the consistent theme throughout the whole venue. I just love it so much. It's so white and new and, you know, spring feel, in terms of like, you know, a new year, new growth, a new life together, that kind of cute, soppy stuff. Yeah, I'm not really that into weddings, but I do like making the venues in Sims 4 because they seem to be received really well, and I think there's so much that can be done with them. One thing I really like doing is adding a little table, especially for the bride and groom, which I've just done there with that round table. And I've not ever done two long tables before. Normally, I do like tables dotted all over. So it also gave me opportunity to use some more table decorations, like these leaves. They look amazing, and they come in different swatches. Of course, they're more, you know, they're meant to be for actual seasonal holidays, but they totally work in this case as well. And I've just pulled through the yellow as well on the tablecloth, so there's like that real spring vibe, and you know, floral blossoms and bloom and all of that good stuff. So yeah, I do add a couple more trees here and there as well, just to, or bushes and stuff, just to kind of fill out the space. And you know, just to kind of make it look balanced, I guess. And yeah, I guess the center is the main event, the center little where the ceremony takes place. And I did toy around with the idea of putting some fairy lights, but honestly, it would have just looked messy. And what I do instead is add some of the Lotus candles from City Living. I dot those all over, and they seem to light up the place in at nighttime really well. So you don't actually need any extra light. I mean, obviously you can add if you want, but it kind of gives that really nice romantic evening vibe if your wedding goes on into the evening. Yeah, just, you know, don't get stuck in the rain. That's the only thing. Like, if it rains at night, your guests won't be very happy. But yeah, so I'm just sort of adding in the landscaping here, and you know, just giving it that realistic touch. And because it obviously is a lounge venue type, like a lot type, it's a lounge. I had to kind of fill in all these random requirements, like a sink. So I just kind of blended a sink into the bathroom, and again, the bathroom's still completely usable. It's totally fine, as is the piano, because I hired a sim as well, and bartender, all of that good stuff. It's all usable, and player tested. So yeah, you don't have to worry about that. And I just kind of like how blank or kind of minimally furnished this middle bit is. It's just kind of got the chairs, and that's it, and the rose petals, and it's like that's the focus of the day, obviously. And yeah, here is where I'm going to dot the candles around. Whether or not the Sims actually go and sit on the chairs, I don't know. I mean, some of them seem to like watch from down off the platform, down the other side. It was a bit rude, but and then there was like one dude stood here just in a knight's uniform, you know, like the knight's outfit. I think it was Jeffrey Landgrab. I don't know. He was just so rude. He just showed up to my wedding, and yeah, just wore the inappropriate outfit. So I'm just putting in some stepping stones around the back, and just sort of, you know, just trying to fill in the blank spaces, because I didn't want to put too much more at this point. It was looking really good as it was, and I didn't want to overdo it. So yeah, here's the light. You can see how well these candles light up the space. So yeah, it wasn't too bad at all. The bar as well, it's got more of a rustic vibe with the cats and dogs chairs. And obviously, the rest of it, I've tried to keep it more glam and more like fresh looking than rustic and country. Because, like I said, that was my barn wedding venue is a very rustic. So I tried to keep it slightly different. Hopefully, I've achieved that. And yeah, this is pretty much it, you guys. So if you'd like to see more wedding venues, more themes, then definitely let me know and give me some ideas. And now that we've got seasons, let me know what type of venues you'd like to see. But that's all for now, guys. So thanks so much for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye.